It is said that the grass looks greener on the other side. As a local DJ for Radio Central Brooklyn, an independent station in Park Slope, Brooklyn, I've heard many people pass comments like, "Man, how lucky is John DenMar? Imagine just sitting around playing music, making comments, laughing and joking while entertaining listeners." Ah, little do they know. I mean, it can be a fun way to make a living, but everyone should realize that every job, no matter what, has its ups and downs. Even when you think you have it easy, sometimes a curveball is thrown to you. You know, maybe I should think about jumping over to the other side and experience how others earn a buck. A banker? A corporate guy? A civil service worker? Nah. Unlike most jobs with recurring routines, a radio DJ's job is to change it up every single day, from the music that is played to what is said. Imagine if you could get away with playing the same songs and saying the same nonsense every single day. Unfortunately, it doesn't work that way. My shift begins at 3 p.m. and ends at 7. Gaspar, our program manager and producer, often reminds me that my time slot is aired during prime time, which runs into rush hour while working folks are heading home. I arrive at the station every day 45 minutes before my shift, just to arrange my program for the day. Just when I thought my day was going smooth, only minutes before the start of my program, Gaspar strolls into my booth. That's when he throws me that curveball I was talking about. In his best civil way possible, he informs me that the past 3 weeks, our ratings at Radio Central Brooklyn have drastically gone down. According to Gaspar, our rival station in the area, Radio One Brooklyn, has this young dame who broadcasts our entire program in French. No one understands a damn thing this French gal is saying, but to many listeners, it sounds convincing. Plus, her music is up to date. "John," he tells me, "you need to get out of the past with this 60s and 70s oldies music and get with the times. It's your job to get us back to the top." That's just great. What on earth am I supposed to do now? Learn another language? It just so happens that this young lady is a French-Canadian from Montreal, Canada, by the name of Danielle Marchand. What Gaspar failed to tell me was that her program airs from 7 p.m. to 11. So how on earth am I in competition with her? They're basically two different time slots. But the producers don't want to hear all that. All they know is that the ratings have dropped, and all because Miss Marchand is the new hot ticket in town. That evening, I couldn't wait to get home and tune her in. Searching for Radio 1 Brooklyn on my radio, there she was, Danielle Marchand. Naturally, I didn't understand a word she was saying, but that didn't matter. Her voice was the sexiest and most seductive I've ever heard. Yet, soft and gentle, I began listening to her on a nightly basis, and eventually, my curiosity got the best of me and had to place her face with the voice. But where and how was I going to meet her? word was out from some crew members at the radio station that every night after she would finish broadcasting her program, she would walk up to the cafe by her radio station and would sit alone for a quiet moment reading a book while sipping on a beverage. I was determined to see who she was that evening. I wasted no time to do so. Unfortunately, that night, the weather had changed rapidly. It began to rain with strong winds blowing hard. As I crossed the street, fighting off that wind and rain, I reached the cafe and peered through the window to get a glance at her. But my vision was blurred from that cold rain in my eyes. Gently rubbing them, my vision was restored and was now able to see clearly what was going on inside. There she was, sitting alone at the table, reading a book with a drink in front of her. I was instantly mesmerized by her beauty. Her hair was soft looking. Her piercing eyes were breathtaking and convincing. Her face was smooth and angelic. She resembled the goddess of love, which took over my heart in just one beat. Looking at her, I sensed loneliness in her life, the need for a friend, a companion. I knew deep inside that I could be that one, and I would do anything in my power to succeed. Have passed by, and I would often think about our magical moments together, moments that could never be erased from my memory, moments that will remain in my heart forever, moments with her, until the time I awake and the world returns to a reality when a thing called life gets in the way.
Infiniment lointain.